Now we'll go over to the red drawer that's, I've got over here is a three stack system. It's black bottom cabinet and then a middle red drawer of three and then a top cabinet. And up here is, it's hard to see, back here is a Snap-on half inch drive torque wrench. It goes from 50 to 250 pound feet. This is a Sears torque wrench, same size. It's just not quite as accurate as a Snap-on. Here is a quarter inch drive, goes from 5 to 50 pound inches. And this is a Snap-on, this is a Matco, this is a Snap-on 3/8 drive, and it goes, now the top drawer is just, this is kind of a junk drawer. I've got air hoses, air guns, chucks, mirrors, magnets, extendable magnets. Let's see, razor blades in handles, tire pressure gauges, little small screwdrivers, acid brushes, knives, another knife. Okay, there's another different air chuck. Here's air, that's an adapter I made. There's different size, right here, there's different size adapters that this one is for the type you see at hardware stores, and this one right here is what you're going to see in automotive shops. So they're slightly different if you look at them side by side, and you can't buy this one when you go to Sears or Lowe's or any of those stores. They only have this one, and so none of your automotive tools, like all my shop stuff at work, have this on them. So I had to convert everything from this to this. So I have that adapter. Okay, so now the next drawer. This is my Snap-on high-performance box-end wrenches. They're metric. They go from like 8 all the way up to 20 millimeter. They're a really nice design. This is like, these the high performance ones as opposed just to the regular box end. These right here are just scissors. These are cutting implements, all the cutting implements I have. There's like 10 snips. These are heavy duty scissors in here. And these tools over here are to get, these are to remove panels from inside of doors. Okay, next drawer. Okay, this is my metric tools, metric wrenches drawer. These are Craftsman Professional Series. I go down to, I think it's a 6 millimeter, and all the way up to 24 millimeter. This little bag right here is metric, little tiny metric wrenches, and I'm not sure, they go down to practically nothing. These are just some extras over here. And then the second drawer is SAE. These are also Sears Professional Series wrenches. They go down from 3/16 all the way up to 1 1/16. And then over here is Snap-on ratcheting flat ratchets, or ratcheting box-ended ratchets. Their nickname is flat ratchets. Here's a set of, these are flare-end wrenches. They're for soft nuts, like when you have, they're around tubing fittings. This open section will make it so you can go, the tubing will fit in there, and then you can go around the nut that way. But that, these will keep you from rounding off the softer nuts that are on tubing. Over here, the black wrenches are Snap-on, kind of an industrial finish wrenches. And that's it for this top box. Now the center box, the top drawer, is these are SAE, or no, these are my metric nut drivers, Snap-on. These are the SAE nut drivers. They're color-coded. The red one is a quarter inch, and then the other red one is a half an inch, so they go from a quarter all the way up to a half inch. Orange is 9/32, yellow is 5/16, 11/32 is green, 3/8 is blue, 7/16 is brown, and then a half inch is red again. So these are the SAE, I have two sets of those in there. Next drawer is my, I call it my precision measuring drawer. I've got a couple of Sterrett mics, and there's another one over here. This right here is what I use to clean out carburetor jets. These are actually tiny drill bits. The smallest one is, is 0.0225 inches. Okay, so they're tiny. They are used to clean out cutting torch heads. Okay, so I use these for cleaning out the carburetor jets because they're so small. Another set of Sterrett pin vices. Oh my gosh, random cattage. We happen to have four cats. This is kind of a noisy one. Panda. See you later, Panda. Pin vices. And then I've got, like, there's a spark plug gauge, gapping tool. Here's just some union twist drill decimal equivalents. This is the same thing. So if you need to tap something, you need to know what size drill to use, and then what size tap will go with that drill bit. This bag right here is, I put this together with some of the information Donnie Boy 73 gave me. And this bag is all the stuff to adjust carburetors or rebuild them. So that's just stuff that's in there. There's another pin vise down here that's got a drill bit in it already. There's a feeler gauge, another spark plug gapping tool. These over here. This right here is a valve spring compressor tool that is for a Briggs, or, well, it's for L-headed small engines. Spark tester. I've got a couple of dial calipers. Here's another spark tester. This is a different type of spark tester. And all this stuff over here is for measuring spark plug gaps. And these are feeler gauges down here. This thing right here is to put the Z-bend in throttle cables. Okay, over here is a Vibratac. It's a tachometer that you can measure. There's a wire in it, and you turn the wire out, and whatever frequency where this little end, you can't see it anymore, you look on here, and that's the frequency of the vibration, so you can tell the RPM of something just by setting that on top of it. Okay. There's some jeweler screwdrivers right there, Sterrett's. I really like Sterrett equipment. They're really high quality and well made. Okay, that's it for this drawer. Now my last drawer here is Snap-on screwdrivers. This thing over here is a magnetizing or demagnetizing tool, so in case you want to make the tip magnetic, so you can pick stuff up with it or not drop it when you put it in the screwdriver, or you can take the magnetism away if you don't need it or want it. These are all Snap-on screwdrivers, and they are flat, Phillips, Positrive, and Torx. They're just all kind of mixed together. Oh, plus I also have right angle picks in here. Okay, so that's just screwdrivers. And that's it for that drawer. Okay, next we're going to be looking in.